Hey guys, how's it going? Good morning, how's everybody? What can I say, man? Marsh fishing. It's been good lately, and it's usually a sight casting type trip, but I did not see many fish today, and in fact I didn't see a lot of bait either. Usually there's mullet jumping everywhere out there. I saw one tail today, and that was it. Everything else was fishing under birds. Tons of birds out there today. I mean, multiple groups, as far as you could see off, just making ruckus and chasing shrimp for the most part. And that's what I was fishing underneath. And I think, you know, a couple of other guys that we were fishing with, or maybe all of them, were doing the same thing. Started out trying for trout early, just because we were trying to fish a little deeper, or I was, because of the water temp, but quickly realized that after I did cast close to the bank, there were some reds still in the shallow. I mean, and some of these reds were in real shallow water, even out in the middle, away from the shorelines. So they were kind of sporadic in the pattern and where they were, but all in all, it was a great morning. We were done quick. I was home by before noon. I think it's still just about 11:50 or so. And the guys I was with, they limited out pretty quick too. Let's get into the video. Hope y'all like it. Stay safe. See you on the next one. It's a little chilly today, but it is beautiful out here. Once again, we're back in the marsh. Today we're fishing with Chris, Wolf's Fishing, Brandon, Clean Fun Fishing, we got him along, Justin, and Oscar. There's a couple of the guys behind me, one of them up ahead. Don't know if the reds are going to be as active as they usually are because of the shallow issue with the shallow and the cold, but we're gonna give it hell anyways. At the very least, maybe find some trout.
Don't you think you should have called to tell me you were coming down? Oh, you look so out of place. on this troubled side of town. It's a place where losers go when they know there's nothing left. And after losing you, I just lost the will to live. Do you believe me now? I told you.
And just getting out to the first intersection, and there are birds working. Look at them. Oscar's already right next to where they're at. This could be super interesting, guys.
It did sprinkle on us for a minute, so I apologize about the water drops on some of the camera shots. I know that's annoying, but I tried my best to wipe them off as I fished along.
This is where I usually catch 20, 22 inch trout right around in this area. I don't know. I don't have any kind of way to find out, but I know they're always holding right here for some reason, especially up against this bank. Some pull to him. Into there, partner. Come on, baby. What's the matter, boy? You look tired. I mean, I am too. Not tired, but I'm cold. Straighten out, boy. Maybe a 21 inch. This thing's got a weird hook in it. Let's give him a measure and let him go. ¼ inches. That's a nice fish. You all right, buddy? Yeah, he's ready. Okay, where there's one, there's more. Uh-oh. Well, there he goes. I don't think he realized he was free yet. Some shrimp popping right straight to your 9 o'clock or 3 o'clock. I've caught a 22¾, but you couldn't see them. The birds are just right above it. And it was like a super lazy, sleepy looking red when it came in. So they're obviously pretty cold.
Yeah. A little different than what we're used to.
Yeah, but damn, look at all the birds, man. I think they're right there. You see where that bird is? Well, you see the shrimp right there where that bird is? There's shrimp popping right there. Yeah, I see the wake now. Get them. Fifth are very lethargic. Fish are very lethargic right now, but they're feeding. They're just real slow moving right now. If these birds here, I don't know if they're on fish or just bait, but. Fish grips ain't working for Shinola. Look at you, pretty girl, or boy, whoever you are. Got like a worm or a parasite on him. Let's see if you hold still for a picture long enough. probably right at 20. God, he's got junk all over him, man. Look at all these little, I don't know what it is. He's 21.
Here's where the birds really paid off for me. This was the last catch of the day. I happened to be trying earlier to catch some trout with this little Paul Brown Softdene lure. And when I saw this big group of birds, I thought I'd try to throw it in there, and this is what happened.
That's a nice red. Oh, that's a big red. Woo, baby. This might be my PB, guys. Yes, sir. Is that a drum? Black drum? Golly, I hope my... Golly, guys. That is a nice drum. Red. He's not hooked very well. Only got probably one of the back trebles in him. Beautiful fish. Oh boy. God almighty. That is a nice, nice red. Oh my goodness. I hope my camera is faced the right direction. That's all I gotta say. My little Paul Brown peanut. definitely my PB red. Don't make fun of me, guys. I've only been fishing for about 2 months. Ooh, look at there. Look at that beautiful fish, guys. Look at him. Just gorgeous. Just under 27. Oh man. 27 inch, that's my PB, man.
Awesome.
All right, calling it a day. It's 9:40 in the morning. Ran into Chris, he's behind me here. He limited out by 8:30. He's got three nice fish. All the fish this morning were good size. I ended out with a very nice red, biggest one I've ever caught. I think it was 26 3/4, just under 27. It was cold, but it was worth it. The marsh always produces.
Come on, man.